know, 2 weeks ago I said I'd see you next week, and then I wasn't there. I was sick, guys. Sorry, but I'm back now, and I'm here to tell you that I get a lot of comments from strangers. I don't know why strangers feel this obsessive need to relay trivial information to me, but they do. One thing I hear very often is that I look like Snow White. I actually had this one lady whom I'm pretty certain thought I was literally Snow White. Like, she brought her children over to stare at me. I got really concerned about her parenting skills. Now, every time someone tells me this, I get a little offended because she's pretty much the lamest princess.
I'm wishing.
Like, there's nothing badass about her.
Or the one I love.
And she sets back feminism a lot.
Today.
I start to get really upset, and really all they're just trying to tell me is that I'm pretty. I don't take compliments well, obviously. But it got me thinking about fairy tales and if they actually are anti-feminist. Back when these stories were written, that's kind of just the way women were. I mean, if you look at the acts that the women do in those stories, they could have been considered incredibly brave for the time. And anyway, because the stories were written before the feminist movement, you can't really say it's setting back feminism. So that being said, why is being compared to Snow White still insulting? I'm gonna tell you. She's dumb. Like, tremendously unintelligent. And I'm basing this on the fairy tale, not the Disney movie. In the story, she's 7 years old, so I tried to give her the benefit of the doubt. But this girl broke into the dwarf's house, noticed that there was fresh, hot food laid out, fell asleep, and then was surprised when she woke up to find people in the house. And when the evil queen disguises herself as the old peddler, I really tried to take Snow White's age into consideration. So when the dwarves told her not to open the door to anyone, she's 7, so there's a good chance that she's gonna be disobedient. But after the third time that she opened the door to certain death, I kinda gave up on her. This has to be genetics, though, because Snow White's mother came up with the most unimaginative name for her daughter. Also, Snow White is crazy. Like, really crazy. Like, it puts the lotion in the basket crazy. After she gets married, she invites the evil queen to the reception, where she forces her to wear red-hot iron shoes and dance herself to death. That escalated a bit. Never heard of banishment? So yeah, not the most ideal person to be compared to. So I'm thinking that the next time someone compares me to Snow White, I'm just gonna set them on fire and then be confused when they start screaming. Because that's what they expected, right? Luckily, Disney has finally caught on to the fact that their female leads have sucked and have created some pretty cool heroines like Mulan and Ariel, and more recently Tiana and Rapunzel and Merida, and of course my favorite, Belle. So, yay! Anyway, I'll see you guys next week, unless I get sick. Bye. And when the evil queen disguises herself, oh my god, I can't speak without when she's 7, so there's a good chance that she's gonna be decent. Why do I talk like this?